In this video, I'll show you how to fix a new SSD not showing up on your computer. If you're new to the channel, please go down below and consider subscribing. And once you've done that, please go down below and consider leaving a like. And let's jump straight into this guide. So if you just gone and installed a brand new SSD and then you went and opened up your file explorer expecting it to be in the device and drive section and it not appearing, well, don't worry because this is completely normal and there's something you need to go and do to go and set it up. So all you need to do is actually go into your search bar and all you want to do is go and type partition. So type in partition just like so. And then what we need to do is go and tap on create and format hard disk partitions, tap here. Then we're gonna go and get this screen here and I'm gonna go and zoom in on this for you guys so it's really clear. And when you first go and open up this disk management application, you're going to go and get a pop-up called initialize disk. And this is basically setting up your disk. And what you need to do is you need to go and tick the drive which you want to go and initialize. It's probably only going to be one if you've installed one. And then make sure you go and select GPT. And the other option will be MBR, and this is your boot drive, but this probably isn't going to be a booting drive. So what you want to do is go and select GPT. And it is important to note that at the moment, I don't have a new SSD because I've already set mine up. But what you need to do is go and find the new SSD. And what it's going to go and do is going to go and say unallocated. In this area here, it's going to have this unallocated thing. Then what you want to do is right click on this area in the, for your new SSD, right click on it, and you need to go and click on new simple volume. And this will open up the new simple volume wizard. And then what you can go and do is go and set the space you want to go and use. I recommend just using the maximum amount you can. Then go and tap on next. And the next thing you can go and do is choose the letter for the drive, and the letters for your drive will go and appear in your file explorer. For example, I've got a C drive, a D drive, an E drive, and an F drive. So I guess I'd go and have an H drive next. Then go and tap on next again, and you now need to go and format your partition. So what I'm recommending for the file system is to go and select the NTFS option, keep the allocation limit size to be default, and then for the volume label, you can go and name that anything you like. Then press next, and then you can go and tap on finish. And then after you press finish, the drive is now going to be appearing in the devices and drive section here. If it doesn't, go and restart your computer and then it will go and appear. And that's literally it, guys. If you found this useful, please go down below and consider leaving a like. Peace.